Hi, I'm Brad. Today I'm going to show you how to move from one external identity provider to another in AWS IAM Identity Center. In this example, we will move from KeyCloak to Okta, but the same general steps will work for all SAML 2.0 identity providers. Please check with your identity provider for specific implementation instructions. This video assumes that you are already using IAM Identity Center with a SAML 2.0 identity provider and are wanting to switch to another IDP or tenant. It also assumes you have migrated desired users and groups to the new tenant and configured Identity Center in that identity provider. So first, we're going to log in as a user in KeyCloak. Now that we see we can log into Identity Center through KeyCloak, we are going to access the administrator panel within KeyCloak and download its SAML 2.0 identity provider metadata. This will help us in case we need to roll back during our configuration changes. Now we need to download our new IDP metadata from Okta. First, select Applications and then select Applications again. Locate your Identity Center application and select it. Now select the Sign On tab and scroll down until you see a More Details link. Click that and we're going to need to download the signing certificate. With the new Federation metadata, we can now switch identity providers in Identity Center. Stay on this page. And in a new page, make sure you're logged into the AWS console as an Identity Center administrator. Select Settings in the left navigation pane. Choose Actions and then Change Identity Source. Here we will select External Identity Provider and choose Next. Under Service Provider Metadata, download that metadata file. We will use it later to configure Okta. Now, going back to our Okta configuration page, copy Okta's single sign-on URL and paste it into the Identity Center settings. Now we will do the same for the issuer URL. Now we must upload the certificate Okta uses to sign SAML assertions by uploading the file we downloaded earlier from Okta. Now the configuration on the Identity Center side is finished. Go ahead and read the warnings contained in the yellow box. And when you're ready to accept, type in accept and the orange change identity source button. Identity Center is now set up to accept SAML assertions from Okta, but we need to set up Okta to accept SAML requests from Identity Center. So return to your Okta page, and on the Identity Center application page, select Sign On. At the top right of the settings box, select Edit. Once we're in edit mode, scroll down to Advanced Sign-On Settings. Here is where we will add information about Identity Center from its SP metadata that we downloaded earlier. We will first take the entity ID value and paste that into AWS SSO issuer URL on the Okta page. Once we have done that, we will grab the value for assertion consumer service, specifically the location URL, and put that as the value for AWS SSO ACS URL in Okta. Once you have updated the ACS URL, make sure that the username format is set as email and save your changes. You can now log in to Identity Center from Okta. The only thing left to do is to enable automatic provisioning via SCIM from your IDP if your IDP supports it and you would like to do that. So, back in the Identity Center console, click on Settings on the left navigation pane. Locate the automatic provisioning box and select Enable. In the inbound automatic provisioning box, copy the SCIM endpoint and access token. Store these in a secure place. Note, this will be the only time you have access to the access token. Now go back to the Okta tenant and make sure your Identity Center application is still selected. Then click on the Provisioning tab. On the Provisioning page, click the Configure API Integration button. Now click on the Enable API Integration checkbox and switch back to your Identity Center admin console, where you still have the SCIM URL and access token up. Go ahead and copy the SCIM access URL and put that in the API integration on the Okta page. And now do the same for the access token. You can click the test connection button to make sure that you've put the URL and access token in correctly. And for Okta, you would need to edit this page to allow Okta to create, deprovision, and update users. To wrap up, we now know how to migrate between external SAML 2.0 IDPs in IAM Identity Center. If you have any trouble with this configuration, remember the following. Consult your vendor's documentation. You can always roll back to the previous IDP using the metadata document that we downloaded at the beginning of the video. Check to make sure all users and groups exist in the new IDP and are assigned to that IDP's SAML application. Review the IDP's SAML assertion, paying particular attention to the following things. The name ID format is set to email, and the name ID value must exactly match the username of a user in Identity Center. This match is case sensitive. If these troubleshooting steps do not help the situation, feel free to open up a ticket with AWS's premium support team, and they'll be happy to look into this for you.